Hi guys, it's Chris with City Girl Homestead. So now another day of really quick meals, so this won't be a really long video or anything, but I'm trying to use things from my freezer, things that are left over, all that good stuff, and we're gonna put together a meal. So if you remember, I went to the Amish store and I got some of the waffle fries. I got my oven preheating for that. And then I just remembered one thing I forgot to get out of the refrigerator. But I'll get that out in just a minute. I could have probably used a full-size one here instead of a part-time size. All right, let's put that in the oven. All right, so now I had a bunch of the meatballs left after I had canned the meatballs. So I'm gonna, and I still have a bunch left even after this. So I'm gonna put my meatballs in this pan. And then remember I had pasta sauce. That was left. So we're gonna pour that over top. All right, let me get a little bit of water and what I forgot and I'll be right back. All right, so I'm gonna pour the rest of that sauce in here. I know this is like, why am I watching this video? How stupid is this? But sometimes it's easy to show a video that's easy, if that makes sense, so that maybe it's things that we might have forgotten to do, or you know, oh man, I've got some meatballs in my freezer. I could do that too. I mean, sometimes we forget about things and we think of leftovers just as things that are in our refrigerator from a meal previous. You know what I mean? And that's not always the case. Then on the side, I'm going to use cottage cheese. And that was already in my refrigerator. And then I had some pineapple tidbits up in my cupboard. So let's put some of those on the pineapple. Don't want to waste none of that pineapple. That stuff has gotten expensive. So. And then I have two more things for recycling. Isn't that good? All right, now, if you remember back when I cooked the veggie subs, I saved the other three sub buns, and we're going to use those. So if we just think of things that we have in our freezers, our refrigerators, all that, sometimes we can throw together a very quick meal. And we didn't spend anything on it. And it ends up being a great meal, right? I think I got that up too high. Let me grab a bread knife. Now these sub buns I got at Sam's. They were, or no, Walmart. And they were, I think, $3. Something like that. And they're still very, very soft because I put them in the freezer the very night that I didn't use them. So, they're still very usable and very, very soft. So now we're going to wait for those meatballs to get completely warmed through because they've been in my refrigerator, unthawing, de-thawing, however you say it. And I'm going to let them get nice and hot. I have my oven on 400 so that I can cook my french fries. And then we're going to put together our meatball subs. So I know it's a very simple video and it's very easy and you're like, Chris, we could do this. But with the times the way that they are right now, things are tight. And, you know, you think about, well, what am I going to feed my family tonight? What am I going to feed my family? You know, and sometimes out of our pantry, our freezers, our refrigerators, our cupboards, whatever. We can find stuff in there to throw together to make a nice meal for our family. So we don't always need to grocery shop. And what I've been doing lately is I've been trying to find meals that I haven't called it clean refrigerator week or anything like that. But what I've been trying to do is put together meals with stuff that I already have. And if I don't have it, then I've been trying to put together like $30 to $50 that I spend on groceries, because things are that tight. And we can't spend all that money just on groceries. And I'm sure I'm not the only one out there that can't spend that kind of money. Excuse me. But if we use up and utilize some of the things that we have, then we can still have a really great meal. Now, I am going to spend money on Thursday. We're going to the Amish Not Amish store, and I will stock up on things. Like, me and Tom have probably already went through like 5 of those salami bags, and I found out today Emmy loves that salami too. And he takes that salami and then that cheese we bought every day for work. And, you know, you've seen us use some of the other stuff up too. And if I can stock my freezer, can it, or it's good on the shelves, and I can save the money that you guys have seen me save, I'm going to do it. Jack really wants to go down there, and I have Emmy on Thursday, so he likes to shop, so let's do it. So tomorrow, there I don't think will be a video. I don't have dinner planned, nothing. My brother's thing is from 12 to 2, and it's about an hour and a half from our house, so if anything, we might stop and get a burger or something, but yeah. Who knows, maybe I'll change my mind and do something quick. I don't know. But I don't think there'll be any video at all tomorrow. Not even a canning, nothing. There will be Thursday. I'm working on my Thankful Thursday now, but it's been taking steps to do it, and hopefully it's done by Thursday. But anyway, so I'm going to let these completely heat through, and then I'll be back. All right, so let's put these subs together. I'm actually not a meatball fan, but I'll eat them. Tom, he could live on them. So I'm going to put the meatballs on the tray, obviously. And I'm going to fill it as full as I can get it. I want to take it right to the edge. I pulled out 18 of them, so that should give 6 per sub. And it looks like it's going to get 5. Hopefully he can eat too, because we thought Jack would be here, but he's going to be at my sister's tonight, so. Look at that. Alright, I don't think you need to watch me fill a sub bun, right? Alright, so I got all those filled. Now I just want to put a little bit of sauce on top of each one, because I think that's part of the sub thing, is to have it saucy. Whatever I have left, I'll put in a little bowl for Tom, and he'll eat them. You'll have to let me know if you have your meatball subs differently. All right, now I'm going to put a little bit of mozzarella cheese on both, or all 3 of them, I should say. Because I was told mozzarella belongs on meatball subs. All I'm sure you could put, you know, different spices on top of that or whatever you wanted to do. You know, that's completely up to you. Like Jack says, my favorite words are you do you, baby. So there's the three subs. I do have my measuring cup over here to the side filled with water so that they'll stay up. Don't want tipped over subs, that's for sure. All right, so I'm gonna let that melt and then I'll be back when everything's put together and Tom can taste it. Hi, Tom.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm just dandy.
Awesome. So there's some extra meatballs, some cottage cheese, there's a
pineapple
meatball sub, and
some
fries.
Waffle fries.
Yeah. So give her a try. I know, I told him you love meatballs. I'm not a fan, but I'll make them for you. I don't know why. I like burgers and stuff. I don't know why I wouldn't like meatballs, but I'm just not the biggest of fans. So how does it taste?
Good.
You notice I melted your mozzarella, not your other cheese on there.
No pepper jack?
No.
Oh, come on.
Nope. Alrighty, so we got the day off tomorrow and we're headed north. So no video. You won't be eating in front of anybody tomorrow. Well, you'll be eating in front of a lot of people, but you know what I mean. So you guys have a blessed night. Be a blessing. And we'll see you Thursday. You guys have a great 2 days. Bye, Tom.
Bye, Tom.